Hello, it's Polish Paul VR, welcome to my channel, and it's this time of the month again. It's time to check out what new PlayStation VR games you're going to play this month. Let's talk about all the known PlayStation VR releases. Of course, this might change, they're gonna probably add more games, which we don't know about yet. Something might get delayed, but nevertheless, this is the list of confirmed games. Thanks to Ruben Gutierrez for donating to my charity fundraiser. If you want to donate, you can go to the description and that's where you find the link. Before I start, if you like what you've seen, then please press a like because it does helps the channel a lot. And if you're new to the channel and are not subscribed, then subscribe. It's always better when it's more of us. Okay, let's do it. On 3rd of September, we get in Blindfold. Now, this is free on the PC. So I'm assuming we might see same on PlayStation VR, unless they're doing some kind of bigger or updated version, which they're gonna charge money. I don't know. If you like 1979 The Revolution, you might like this one. You're getting interrogated and it's all terrible. But apparently the experience is good.
Everything you do has consequences.
Tell him what he wants to hear. Behesh Begu, confess that you are the leader.
When I ask you a question, you will answer by nodding your head. Perhaps you are a sympathizer as well. Are you ready to confess?
Also coming on 3rd and also for free is Dream Match Tennis Online Mode. This is your tennis game. Now plays very good, very nice little game, but of course we all like multiplayer and playing against human person. Spice and Wolf VR coming on 5th. Now this is coming from the developers of Project Lux, and from what I heard, Project Lux wasn't that greatly received. Some people just hated it, how it was all constructed, how much reading there was, but of course it's visual novel, but how the reading was presented to you on the screen all the time, some subtitles disappearing too fast, sometimes staying too long, always obstructing your view.
VR.
Angry Birds Movie 2 VR disc version coming to you from Perp Games. Now this is releasing first in Europe, coming to US at later date. We already had Angry Birds game in VR, but it was like your proper Angry Birds experience just translated to the virtual reality. This one is a bit different. This one is more of a team-based game. When you like in submarine, you are in VR and your friends are playing on flat. It's all about the communication and fun. Borderlands 2 VR DLC. Finally, it's coming. In the background, I'm playing the video from the trailer for Tiny Tina and the Assaults on the Dragon's Keep, because that was the one you asked me the most about. All of them coming, all 16 pieces of the DLC. You get in all the new characters, all the extra heads and skins and shit, but also you get in all the 4 major DLC plus 4 smaller Headhunter packs, so you get in a lot. This game gonna get around twice bigger now.
Fantasy World!
So, you made it at last. Well, you're a bit too late to save your precious little queen, but hey, at least you get to die in unimaginable freaking pain.
Okay, how about a new boss?
I am Mr. Booty Pants Guy.
This ain't gonna protect me from balls, but I feel pretty hot right now, ain't gonna lie.
Handsome sorcerer here. See, I kidnapped your queen like 3 hours ago. She's already in my tower. Thanks for helping me summon the Ghost King here, though. That was nice. Have fun dying!
That gun fires exploding swords! I did not know the meaning of happiness until this moment!
I hear you need help defeating the Ghost King. If you can help me, I'll help you.
Whoa, wait a minute! You're the jackass who killed Ragnar the Emancipator! Die! Lightning bolt!
Magic missile!
Fireball!
The handsome sorcerer's pet dragon appears! Surprise attack!
Finally, I'm free to wreak my vengeance upon the world!
Okay, and on 10th from the developer Survios, a very, very good developer, coming another polished game, what it looks like, very nice looking experience. Battle Wake, you're gonna have single player campaign, but also you're gonna have co-op campaign. Whatever you're doing single player, you can play with your friends, and it's gonna have player versus player as well.
Set sail in Battle Wake, a seafaring combat game where 4 ancient, super-powered pirate lords fight for ultimate dominion.
Fire the broadsides!
Captain a massive, battle-ready ship, navigate lush, elemental seascapes, and prepare for a larger-than-life pirate war of the ages. Relive the tall tales following 4 fearsome pirate lords in Battle Wake's narrative solo or co-op campaign mode. Become Diego, a Spaniard who's equal parts charming and cunning. Rev, a fanatic transformed by her mad devotion to the Drowned One. Calavera, an undead pirate legend with a bone to pick. Or Zhang, an ancient immortal empress who commands the deadly Jade Empire fleet. Each pirate lord has been bestowed with supernatural powers and devastating ultimate abilities. Unleash the might of the ocean. Send your enemy's ships flying, and literally release the Kraken.
Crush them! Crush them all!
In Battle Wake's Warfare mode, up to 4 players will be forced to work together to complete dynamic, increasingly difficult mission objectives, collecting gold to upgrade your ships and abilities along the way. Or just cut the formalities and embrace the pirate's life in Plunder mode, a free-for-all PvP deathmatch.
Sink any pirate you see and take everything you can from their driftwood.
Command your ship vessel outfitted for war to sink enemies' fleets and seaside fortresses with an arsenal of flat cannons, ballistae, and more. From your captain's quarters, spend gold earned from matches to boost your ship's stats and arsenal, as well as leveling up your own skills and abilities. Whichever captain has your allegiance, whatever pirate ambition you choose to pursue, Battle Wake is a colorful, rip-roaring adventure with one-of-a-kind nautical gameplay and a healthy dose of chaos.
I hold up my end of the bargain. What about yours?
On 10th, we get in No Man's Sky Beyond. This version, No Man's Sky Beyond update, was amazing, of course for free, but if you are a collector and want another No Man's Sky game in your collection, then you can buy it on the disc. Now, I'm being asked a lot about this pro patch because, as we know, on PS4 the game is kind of blurry. Nevertheless, even though it is blurry, people losing hundreds and hundreds of hours in this game, it's still amazing, but No Man's Sky VR Pro Patch is highly requested feature. Now, I wonder if with this disc release, maybe Pro Patch will be ready then, I don't know. I know they've had some more priorities to sort it out first after the update release. What's happening is basically the update was huge, but there was few issues, you know, few bugs to fix and a lot of stuff to do from the developers to make this experience smooth as possible. Kind of can expect after huge update like that, there's always something will be in the way of making it awesome, but they pretty much managed to get on top of it now. So hopefully next priority for them will be PlayStation VR Pro Patch. I looked at the box on the pre-order websites, it says it's Pro optimized, but of course it is, because flat version is utilized for Pro. VR not yet, but let's hope they're gonna give this Pro patch very soon. But like I said, this game is amazing anyway. Yes, it's blurry, yes, there's a lot of popping, but also what there is a lot of awesome gameplay time. If you decide to buy this game, if you're on the fence yet, just go and get it. You're gonna lose days and days in it. Such an addictive game. So many people playing. It's got crossplay with flat PlayStation 4 people. No crossplay with PC, but there is definitely enough players to play online, and there's so much stuff to do. You can go to explore, you can go just base building, you can do some missions, you can play in creative mode if you don't like grinding. Definitely game that anyone can pick and play. Coming on 17th is Groundhog Day, like father, like son, coming from the developer Tequila Works. They already did amazing Invisible Hours. Groundhog Day is different kind of game, but nevertheless another good looking game. Based on the movie, actually it's a sequel to the movie, so you play in as a son of the dude and you kind of move out of city, then come back and it's all gone to shit, and you're reliving Groundhog Day over and over again.
Good morning!
There's my mom, Rita. Little known fact, she's actually won a ton of awards for producing local TV, like best documentary no one's watched.
Did you wake up on the wrong side of the bed?
Come take a look at the espresso machine. I can't make it work.
I used to think I knew my brother. Until today. The one day I get stuck at home is the day Jake decided to be an angry, miserable son of a...
Bing! There's that classic Connors dry wit.
You all know Ned Ryerson. I know, many of you look at him and say, wow, a guy so relentlessly positive, he probably still thinks his flip phone is cool.
Was it great or was it great? Or was it great?
Impress me.
Internet, you're in for a real treat. This is Sarah, my ex. Whatever.
You're making a mess.
That's right, I'm back in my hometown and taking you with me. Sorry, not sorry.
VR Ping Pong Pro, a sequel to VR Ping Pong, a little game which kind of, well, it was alright, it wasn't great, but came out in the early days of PlayStation VR's lifetime, so not that much advanced VR game, but this one looks like a big improvement over it. Also, this one getting physical release, if you like your games on the disc. Now, the biggest game of the month that I cannot wait for is Aspyr 1 VR finally coming on September 24th. It's meant to come out in August, but sadly it got delayed. Developers needed a bit more time to just polish the game and make it as awesome as possible. Now, this one looks amazing. Everyone's saying it's a combination of Metal Gear Solid and GoldenEye 007, which was two awesome games back in the day, so definitely nice combination. Stealth, shooting, great controls, no motion sickness. On a longer side, when it comes to VR games, for the campaign you're looking at around 6 hours and then you unlocking as well tons and tons of challenges. Cannot wait, 24th cannot come soon enough.
Sure to complete your objectives and make the most of Aspyr 1's abilities.
Freeze.
From within the Aspyr Control Theater, you will precisely control Aspyr's every action for the first time in VR. Agent, experience full freedom of movement without motion sickness. Together, we will redefine espionage.
Now, that was the games with confirmed release date, but nevertheless there is some more stuff that coming in September, just they didn't told us what they yet. And we're gonna start from Doctor Who, The Edge of Time. Now, this one is for the fans of the series, based on the latest series, which I'm hearing it's not that great. I don't know, I never really watching Doctor Who, but if you are a fan, you're gonna be able to fly TARDIS and everything is very, very nicely recreated. The developers pretty much giving fans of the series a proper fan service, so if you like Doctor Who, then you should get excited. Now, Racket Fury multiplayer, this is not 100% confirmed, but it should be out in September, finally. The developers struggle with this update, but finally, apparently, it's nearly ready. Now, the update is out on everything else. There's multiplayer on PC and on Quest, and there is a bit of an issue which causing a slight delay. Not much, but enough for Sony to say, no, you need to fix it. That is the issue for PlayStation VR, and that's what they were struggling with. They didn't pass Sony's certification process last time again, but they already applied for new one, and finally it should be out in September, and of course the developer saying this will be 100% free. And The Station, now this is more of a rumor, but the game is already on pre-order on some Spanish website, and apparently it's coming out in September, but take it with a grain of salt, because it's been on pre-order in UK stores as well, and that was with July release date, but it looks like it, should be out in September, but it's not 100% confirmed. But I just want to put it out there because it looks like it's getting very close to release. So what you're gonna have to do, if you buy Deluxe Edition, then you're gonna have VR within the disc, on the disc. But if you already own the station, then you're gonna have to pay for extra DLC. And that's it, bye.